Okay, good morning to all. I think today we are going to discuss about the vapor power cycles. Already we have discussed about the classification of thermodynamic cycles in detail in last lecture. Then afterwards introduction to Carnot cycle, then efficiency, how to calculate the efficiency of Carnot cycle, and then limitations of Carnot cycle. And by that limitations here, we came to know that Rankine cycle some limitations were removed in the Rankine cycle, and introductory part of Rankine cycle also we have covered day before yesterday. Is it correct? We will revise some whatever we have learned in the last lecture, and then we'll go ahead. Is screen visible to all? Is screen visible? Okay. So last lecture, I think we have started with the vapor power cycles. So syllabus, which syllabus we have started. So ideal Reed cycle and ideal Reed cycle are also one of the Rankine cycles are there. Rankine cycles or vapor power cycles are there, but that we are not discussing now, because this is not included in our syllabus, current syllabus. So with that syllabus, then with central idea, we have started the unit. Then we have discussed about the classification of thermodynamic cycles. So these thermodynamic cycles are classified into mainly two categories. One is power cycles and another is refrigerant cycles. So depending on the aim, that is, sometimes we need the power. And two laws are there of second law. That is, one is Clausius statement and another is Kelvin-Planck statement. So our Kelvin-Planck law is related to power cycle or engine, and another Clausius law is related to refrigeration. And depending on that, these thermodynamic cycles based on these two laws are classified into two categories. One is power cycle and another is refrigerant cycle. So is it clearly visible? All the screen now today you can I'm in proper format, so I think as usual, so you can chat also, chatting. Okay, good. Others also reply, so it is not the lecture of three four students and teacher. Everybody I request to note down doubts are there, ask them, be in interactive mode. So thermodynamic cycles are mainly classified into two categories. One is a power cycle, another is refrigerant cycle. Then power cycles are again divided into two categories. One is related to vapor power cycles and another is gas cycles. The gas cycle side, we are learning gas cycles again, they are classified into two categories. One is IC engines and another is your external combustion engines. External combustion engine, nothing but what? Gas turbine cycles. So this is related to external combustion. This is related to combustion is taking place outside the cylinder. So this is called as external combustion. So gas turbines are external combustion engine cycles. And IC engines, I think you are learning one subject, IC engine, therefore not to go in detail. ऐसे ही सारा अगेन क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू कैटेगरी. वन इज व्हाट, टू स्ट्रोक, फोर स्ट्रोक, ओके, और डिपेंडिंग ऑन द फ्यूल इंजेक्शन प्रिंसिपल, एसआई इंजन एंड सीआई इंजन. सो आई कैन राइट हियर एसआई सीआई, ओके, एंड देन दिस साइड वी आर हैविंग द वेपर पावर साइकिल्स. सो वेपर पावर साइकिल्स आर फॉर मेनी साइकिल्स आर देयर, कार्नोट साइकिल, रैंकिन साइकिल, आइडियल रीड साइकिल, आइडियल रीजन साइकिल, एंड वन मोर इज दैट इट इज सुपर क्रिटिकल रैंकिन साइकिल. सो दिस इज not these cycles are not included in our syllabus. So only ideal cycle, ideal region cycle and supercritical, they are not included in our syllabus, but we are having only to study Carnot cycle and Rankine cycle. So supercritical, Rankine cycle. Supercritical Rankine cycle. So this is one of the again one cycle. Then Carnot cycle is one of the ideal cycle that we have learned on that day, and Rankine cycle also we have started some introduction. And then reference cycle side again, these are classified into two categories. One is vapor cycles, vapor reference cycles, and air cycles. So air cycles are used for the aeroplane refrigeration or air reference cycle, air refrigeration purpose. And these cycles are types are according to scientist name, so Joule cycle and Breton cycle. These are some examples. And vapor power cycle, again vapor cycle. So reference cycles are depending on the ejecting of vapors, how we are ejecting, by compressing or by absorbing. So depending on that, vapor cycles are classified into two categories. One is vapor compression reference cycles and vapor absorption. So this is called as VCC cycle in short. And whatever the previous refrigerators are there in our home, household refrigerators are there, okay, industrial refrigerators are there, makes mostly they are working on the vapor compression reference cycle. Air conditioning systems are also working on vapor compression reference cycle. So this is having less COP, vapor absorption reference cycle. So it is used very rarely, but nowadays because of the pollution and that protocol is there, that is some refrigerants were to ban because they are harmful to ozone, they are depleting the ozone layer, and therefore some refrigerants which are the powerful refrigerants, which are having good performance, that kind of R12, R22, these are names of refrigerant. So you will come to know in one subject, that is refrigeration and air conditioning. So in that, that protocol committee is there, international protocol is there, that is we have to ban such kind of refrigerants because they are harmful to our life. They are depleting the ozone layer. This hydrocarbon, HCFC or CFC refrigerants are there. Generally, they are made up of hydrocarbons, okay, hydrofluorocarbons, and they are depleting the ozone layer, and which is very much important for us. Otherwise, direct harmful sun rays will come to us, and the life on Earth or life on Earth will be get destroyed, and it will be difficult to then survive. Therefore, these refrigerants once summit is there in international level and they have started that, these refrigerants we have to stop. Then alternative refrigerant systems or alternative refrigeration systems or refrigerants we have to search. And in that case, vapor absorption systems came into picture. And these are famous nowadays. So in some of the countries, to make the air conditioning of entire apartment, entire village, okay, so these vapor absorption systems are used. Okay. So, and then, okay, so these are the vapor compression and vapor absorption. Otherwise, vapor compressions are famous because of the compact size and because of the more COP. So, these cycles we have wanted to study in the, okay. And next, this power cycles also gas cycles, one subject is there for you, gas turbine cycles. I think if you are learning nowadays, gas turbine cycles you learn in some of the subjects or as one or two topics in maybe in future third year, okay. Maximum these cycles we are going to study in our mechanical engineering. So our today's learning or for this chapter we are going to focus on this. We have maximum vapor power cycle, and these are Carnot cycle, Rankine cycle, ideal reed cycle, ideal regenerative cycle, and supercritical. Out of that also three cycles we have removed, but for basics we are going to learn. So vapor power cycles mainly they are divided into two categories. That is, or there are two types. One is the Carnot vapor power cycle. It is invented by study Carnot, and therefore the name is given at Carnot River Port Cycle. And there were some many limitations are there. Practically, this Carnot cycle was not possible. So why this Carnot cycle is not possible? So last lecture, I think we have seen, okay, learned. So I want some revision on this now. So this is okay. Everybody understood this revision? And I want answer from your side that why Carnot vapor power cycle is not a real cycle, or it is practically possible cycle. Okay, Asmira sir, everybody understood? Others please reply. And who will answer my question? Okay, why Carnot vapor power cycle is not exist or is exist in the real case? It is only remained on the theoretically. Anybody of you? Unmute or chat box also if you are in that writing speed more. Anybody of you can answer this? Why Carnot vapor power cycle is not exist in real case? On that day I have invested more than 50 to 20 minutes on this. Still I am revising very slowly because we're having lots of time. Anybody of you? Carnot vapor power cycle, why it is not in realistic? It is only remained as an ideal case. So one chart I got here. Okay, asking everybody only due to incomplete condensation in compressor. Not compressor, it is in condenser. Incomplete condenser. Why? Then what will happen? And you can unmute and tell us, Mita. It is not in compressor, condensation happens in condenser. And due to that, what will happen? Compressor have to deal the mixture of liquid and vapor. And such type of compressor is not manufactured. So condensation is incomplete because of the in the condenser. And due to that, we have to deal the compressor have to deal the mixture of liquid and vapor. And such type of compressor is not available in the market nowadays also. It's not invented. And therefore, this Carnot cycle remained on paper. Okay. So here, Carnot cycle we have learned. Then Carnot schematic of Carnot cycle we have learned. So one is a boiler is one of the important component which is generating the steam. The boiler steam is here. Boiler takes the heat from the fuel. Fuel is burned into the boiler, and fuel with the help of the heat released from the combustion of the fuel, the water inside the boiler is converting into what steam. So this steam is having high pressure. Okay, so this high pressure, high temperature steam is high pressure. And high temperature steam is produced into the boiler, means it is having high enthalpy, high thermal energy steam is produced into the boiler. Okay. And this steam we are supplying to the turbine. And this turbine will what will happen? In the turbine, these turbines are consisting of blades or shaft. Okay, on that shaft, blades are fixed. So this steam, high enthalpy steam is impacted, inject here or strike. Okay, here strike is get strike on these particular blades. The blades will rotate. Okay. And as these blades are connected to the shaft, shaft will rotate. Okay, and this will generate this particular air. Shaft is rotating, the mechanical work is developing because it is displacement, it is rotary displacement. So no work is developed. This here, let us consider that QS amount of it is supplied from the boiler. Okay, then W amount of work will get, and QR is some amount of heat will be rejected to the condenser. So here work is happened, means expansion is happened. Due to that pressure of that steam will be decreased, temperature also get decreased, then low pressure, low temperature steam here, I think it is with the help of low pressure and low temperature steam. Okay, after expansion, the lay enthalpy will also absorb because maximum enthalpy is converted into work. Therefore, very less enthalpy, less heat is remained with the steam, and this steam is going to be passed to the condenser. Okay, low temperature. Okay, in the condenser, this low pressure, low temperature steam is supplied, it is get condensed, and that condensate is came to the supply to the compressor, and this compressor have to deal the then but and this compressor will compress the condensate coming from the condenser and again return to the boiler, because it pressure decreased in the steam turbine because of the expansion. Again compression, the pressure is increased up to the boiler pressure and supplied to the boiler. So this is the schematic, and we have given the names as 1 to 2. So it is our nomenclature. 1 to 2 is what? Here, not here 1, here not, here it will not be 2. Okay. Point number 2 is here, after condense, after steam turbine, point number 2, okay, and 2 to 3 is what, here condensation 2 to 3, and 3 to 4 is compression, so we are given the name, and 4 to 1 in boiler process, the process, boiler process 4 to 1, 1 to 2 is turbine, steam process in steam turbine, 2 to 3 process in heat condenser, and 3 to 4 is compression, compressor process, so 1 to 2 is isentropic expansion of steam into the steam turbine. Okay, it is expansion isentropic, reversible and adiabatic. The isentropic means reversible adiabatic. In MCQ they will ask, what do you mean by isentropic means reversible adiabatic. Remember always, in MCQ type of examination is there. So isentropic means reversible adiabatic. Okay. Then 2 to 3 is 1 to 2 is here isentropic expansion steam turbine, 2 to 3 isothermal heat rejection in condenser, then 3 to 4 isentropic compression in compressor, and 4 to 1 isothermal heat addition in boiler. So always in cycle there are two processes are applied, one when it some 1 to 2 is expansion, then 3 to 4 is compression, 2 to 3 is heat rejection, then 4 to 1 is heat addition. So here this are the, this is all the processes. So we have covered this last time. Then we have discussed about the PV diagrams and PV diagram of the cycle compressor. So this is the PV diagram of the compressor here, Carnot cycle. So we, this is our cycle is bounded by a curve only. So we know that this is going to be this is going to be bounded by saturation curve, okay, then this will be your saturation curve, okay, let it diamond thank you yeah, and this process 1 to 4 to 1, so we are going for 4 to 1, so okay, so this will be 4 to 1 process. So 4 to 1, is it clearly visible to you all? So this is 4 to 1 is going to be the constant heat, isothermal heat addition in boiler, okay, then 1 to 2 will be isentropic expansion in steam turbine, 2 to 3 will be here heat, isothermal heat addition in condenser, thermal heat rejection condenser. Okay, then 4-to-1 will be isentropic compression compressor. So as this due to these two processes, one is in the condenser processes and another is in boiler processes. So these due to these two processes here, the cycle will restricted into the saturated curve. So we know that this is going to be critical point is there, CP critical point. So this line represent this air saturated liquid. All the points on this line are liquid points. And vapor saturated vapor lines means all the points on the saturated vapor lines are vapor or in gaseous form. So 4-to-1 is there. It is going to be air steam water is entered into the boiler. Okay, it is isothermally heated. Okay, in the phase change only we know that temperature remaining constant. Therefore, in this phase change region, the temperature remaining constant and process will become isothermal. So 1-to-2 there. Therefore, if we came outside the curve, then definitely process will not be phase change will get over. After phase change, temperature will suddenly will not suddenly, but it will increase. Therefore, this process will be here isothermal in phase change only during the phase change in the curve. Therefore, the cycle is restricted in this region. Otherwise, after curve or before curve, the temperature will not remain constant. So, 1-to-2 will be isentropic expansion that we learn. Therefore, 3 points have to be here only because 4 points cannot be go outside. Therefore, to get this 4 point here on this, the 3 point will become this. And therefore, if 3 point is coming on this side means what? This is completion of condensation process on these 3 points. And due to that, what will happen? Condensation process complete incomplete. Therefore, compression process will start here. The compressor have to deal the mixture of liquid here. Three number state means it is liquid plus vapor, not completely liquid, not completely vapor. Some here maximum part of vapor, but some part of liquid. Therefore, it compressor have to deal the mixture of liquid plus vapor. And such type of compressor is not manufactured, which will compress the mixture. Okay. Therefore, 3-to-4 will here. Therefore, if we this point number 3 which is coming on the this liquid line, we can say clearly condensation, complete condensation will get. But this is not possible in Carnot cycle. And then afterwards, the TS diagram, 4-to-1 is going to be isothermal heat addition, therefore bonds, TS diagram, and then isentropic expansion, therefore, this is a vertical line. Okay. Then heat rejection, therefore, again, we are going to this side, and isentropic compression. Okay. And due to that here, this will become more square. Okay. And in due to this here, this is temperature T4 is equal to T1, TS1 is equal to S2, and T3 is equal to T2. And depending on now efficiency of Carnot cycle, we can find out efficiency is equal to work obtained divided by heat supplied. Therefore, work eta Carnot is equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. Well, because work obtained is where I can go for this kind of air. It is a heat engine, or we can say the turbine is acting as heat engine here because it is developing work. Device which develops the work from are called as heat engine. So steam turbine is acting as heat engine, okay, taking Q1 amount or QS amount or Q1 or QS, you can take QS or Q1 amount of heat from the boiler. A boiler is acting as source. Let us consider source is at temperature T1, okay, and it is supplying QS amount of heat or T1. You can track Q1 also. Some amount of heat is rejected. It is QR. Where it is rejected? To the sink, and that sink is acting here. Which what is acting as sinker? Anybody of you? Only I am speaking. Interaction should be there. What is sinking here in this case? Sink will be a temperature T2. Where it is rejected? No answer. T2 is sink. It is okay. Condenser. Sink has low temperature, but yeah, correct. Asmita one Sarvode is giving answer, condenser, very good. So this is going to be sink has low temperature, very good. Clear now, but it is what where it is rejected, it is in condenser. So it is in sink is acting as a condenser. Sink means it is a condenser, low temperature device is condenser, high temperature device is boiler. So source is acting as boiler. Okay. So here we can say that efficiency. So eta Carnot is equal to work obtained divided by heat supplied. Heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by heat supplied. Eta Carnot is equal to QS minus QR divided by QS. Okay. it because work is equal to QS minus QR, but heat supplied is QS, okay, QS minus QR upon QS. But due to this is, as this is a isothermal heat addition process, therefore we can get that here DS is equal to what? Generally we can say it is integration of dQ by T at it is compressed air. Constant temperature means it is dQ, this integration of dQ means Q is equal to what? T into DS. For isothermal processes, we can say it is only possible that you can do this kind of interaction, that is Q into DS. So DS means change in entropy during that process. So therefore, heat supplied is nothing but QS is equal to what? T temperature, T1 temperature, because T1 is equal to T4, T1 into bracket S1 minus S4. Similarly, heat rejected will be here T2 temperature into bracket S2 minus S3, T2 into bracket S2 minus S3. But S1 is equal to S2 and S3 is equal to S4. Therefore, this will become what? Q rejected will become what? T2 into bracket S1 minus again S3 is equal to S4. Okay. So similarly, they are going to become same. And therefore, next slide, you can say that QR or eta Carnot is equal to what? Eta Carnot is equal to what? T1 into bracket S1 minus S4 minus T2 into bracket S1 minus S4. Because S1 is equal to S2 and S3 is equal to S4. So we can put here and divide by if supplied is T1 into bracket S1 minus S4. Okay, so this S1 minus S4 we can take common, it will get cancelled. And this will, what will happen? This will get common, will get cancelled, and it will, what will remain? As our Carnot cycle, in general, we have studied in first law, basic laws of thermodynamics, okay, is equal to 1 minus T2 upon T1. So here also, Carnot vapor cycle, its efficiency will also depends on anybody. I want explanation from your side. I have, I'm sorry, earlier, I have muted you all. I have not made the provision to unmute yourself. Now I have made the provision 1 minus T2 upon T1. Now you can interact by chatting also. So what is this? Is a function of what? Carnot cycle efficiency is a function of my, here efficiency depends on temperature. Okay, Prerna, good, very good. So efficiency depends on temperature, and one is low temperature and one is high temperature. So T2 is less than, and T1 is what? If T1 should be as much as possible and T2 should be as low as possible. And here we can get this eta Carnot. Everybody getting, so for getting the maximum efficiency of Carnot cycle, or we can get some idea from the Carnot cycle that to get the maximum efficiency of vapor power cycle, here heat rejection should be happen at a very less temperature, low temperature, and heat addition should be happens at very high temperature, T1. Okay. Understand, then we have discussed about the limitations of Carnot cycle. So this is the efficiency. Similar to Carnot cycle, here Carnot vapor power cycle efficiency function of two temperature, heat utilization temperature and heat rejection temperature. Heat addition temperature and heat rejection temperature. Then due to here limitation also we have discussed, due to here isothermal heat addition process, here superheating is not possible. Then condensation is not complete because partial condensation, due to incomplete condensation, compressor have to deal the mixture of liquid and vapor, and hatch compressor have to deal the vapor, size of compressor will increase, the work input required size is going to be, as it is going to be deal the vapor, if liquid is dealt, then size will be less, and if vapors are where to deal, then size will increases, and size increase means for compression, work input will be required will be more. And this will reduce some of the amount of work, and then up to work ratio. Discuss about it. And compression and expansion are isentropic. So this limitation remains still in Carnot Rankine cycle also. So we have got these limitations, and therefore we have switched over to which cycle? Anybody of you? Anybody of you? We have moved to Rankine cycle. Good assumption. Others please reply. Okay, Prerna and only Asmina, they are replying. Therefore, we have discussed where last time we have switched over to cycle that is Rankine cycle. So what is change in the Rankine cycle? First change, who will tell? By observing the schematic. We have gone for the schematic, I think. Introduction part we have gone. Anybody of you? What is first change in schematic? Rankine PERM. Okay, PERM is coding language. Okay. So PERM means what? Instead of compressor, we are using PERM. Why PERM? Because your condensation is becoming complete. And first change is that here Rankine has replaced the two isothermal processes of Carnot cycle by isobaric processes. So whatever the two processes are there in boiler, okay, in boiler and in condenser, the processes will not be isothermal, it will be isobaric. Isobaric means temperature remaining, temperature is varying, but what? Pressure is only remaining constant. Okay, so Rankine has replaced two isothermal processes of Carnot cycle by isobaric processes. It consisting of four processes. Then this heat addition and heat rejection is what? Isobaric in case of Rankine cycle. And due to this condition removed isothermal, therefore cycle can come outside the this saturation curve, because after saturation curve temperature is increasing, okay, before or after. Therefore heat is heat addition and rejection are isothermal. Heat addition and heat rejection are isothermal in case of the Rankine cycle. Okay. Therefore, one is a boiler, one is steam turbine, and another is condenser, and one is pump. Okay. So 1 to 2 happens as usual. It is going to be 1 to 2 will be isentropic expansion in steam turbine. Okay. So boiler is producing the steam. The steam is having high pressure, high temperature, high enthalpy. So this steam will here strikes on the blades of the turbine. Okay. This turbine consisting of blades, and these blades are attached to the shaft. Okay. As these blades are, so isothermal or isobaric, as well as, okay, it is isobaric. So processes are isobaric. So it will be, okay. So heat rejection and isothermal are isobaric. Remove this isothermal processes. I think it is writing mistake. So, thank you, sir. Asmita. Okay, isobaric processes. So, okay, so 1 to 2 will be this boiler is producing high amount of high thermal energy steam, having high temperature, high pressure. This steam is impacted on the blades of the turbine. These blades are connected to the shaft. The steam will impact before that one nozzle is there. So, after one, we are having this. The nozzle will increase the kinetic energy of that steam, okay, and this steam, highly kinetic energy steam, is impacted on the blades of the turbine. So this steam will exchange their momentum to the blades. Blades will rotate. These blades are connected to the shaft. Therefore, shaft of the turbine is going to be rotated. And here, due to this, here we can generate the work. The work is generated, okay, from the turbine. Then here, some amount of heat, whatever is there, QS, let us consider again same case. QS amount of heat is supplied, is rejected is QR, and W is going to be obtained. And then this high, low pressure, low temperature steam is rejected to the condenser. Heat rejected from the condenser to the condenser, and it removes the heat, and it will again convert that condenser into that steam into liquid form. And this, but it is complete condensation, because we are not having limitation of isothermal process. The complete condensation will occur here in this case, if you observe. Okay, then 3 points will occur here. And as it is a complete condensation, after condenser, we are getting pure liquid. And to compress the pure liquid, what we have to do? Which device we have to use? Pump. So this pump will increase, because in the turbine, as it is expansion takes place, the pressure is going to be decreased of the fluid, working fluid. And therefore, to increase the work temperature, pressure of the working fluid, we have to use the pump. Pump will now increase the pressure up to the boiler pressure, and it is isentropic compression process. Okay, 4:1, 3:4, and 4:1 is heat addition in boiler. Now we can go for the PV diagram. Up to now, is everybody understand? Please reply. I want that reply from everybody now. Only reply from Asmit and Prerna one today. I will not sufficient. This will not be sufficient. I want from everybody that are attending this lecture. Actually, my here at least more responses I should get. Otherwise, I will. Session should be. I am not asking to tell anybody. Please write reply. Those will write reply. Their attendance I will consider. I am getting the Prerna Vankhede. Okay, no problem. If not understanding, please ask me. Those will reply here. Those attendance only maximum. Those are conversation happens. Those student attendance I will consider. Vishal Metkari, thank you. Now understood. Okay. Others, please reply. Reply fast. Okay, so okay, we will now. I will apply strictly that condition. Those will reply or give conversation messages in the chat box. Their attendance only will consider. Okay, Dipali Kore, thank you. Understand. Okay, now here we can go for this. This saturation curve is there. Okay. This is critical point at as usual. Okay, right hand side of the critical point is nothing but what it is vapor line, and here it will be liquid line. So all this part here up to critical point on this liquid line, all the points, all the states are liquid. All this is all states are vapor. So we'll start from 4:1 boiler. The boiler is taking working fluid as water, but this is having temperature less than saturation temperature water. Therefore, this point will come here. And as this is a 4 point, because there is no limitation of isothermal. Therefore, point number 4 can come outside the before the or left hand side of the liquid line. So 4:1 process will start from here. So condensate is having or boiler water is having pressure equal to boiler pressure after pump. Okay, so this pressure will be, this water will get heated. Let us consider that the steam generated is what, dry and saturated. So here condition steam dry and saturated steam is generated. Okay, so this will completely vapor. Okay, then afterwards 1:2 will be there. It is isentropic expansion. Expansion means pressure is goes on decreasing. Okay, this is highest pressure in boiler, lower pressure in condenser. So pressure is goes on decreasing, okay, and volume goes on increasing. So like this line is there, not like this. So let us wait, consider this as point number 2. Okay, so this is isentropic expansion. This happens in which device? Steam turbine, to it, right? Okay, then 2:3. Now 2:3 is what? Complete, because point number 4 is outside. Therefore, point 2 we can go for complete condensation. Condensation means heat is rejected like boiler. It is here volume is as it is vapor, more volume as it is condensing, it is getting compressing, means the volume is goes on decreasing, and therefore this vapor is get converting into liquid. So this vapor is converting into what? Liquid. Okay, and 3:4. What is their process? 3:4. Now all the, it is entire liquid is there. Therefore, we have to use pump. Okay, and here in this case, pump means we have to compression is there. The pressure is goes on decreasing and volume is goes on increasing. So this will be like this. Volume is goes on decreasing. Okay, so this is point number 4. This happens in boiler. I write as a boiler B. A steam turbine, this happens in condenser, this happens in pump. Okay, point number three is now complete condensation is there. And then everybody understand PV diagram? PV diagram, everybody understand? Okay, Asmita understood. Others, please reply. Prerna, one can also understand. I think last time we have read drawn diagram, PV diagram, Asmita. Asari Bhosle, very good, understand. Vijay Bhar Mahaj, Asmita, okay, very good. Like this, replies, at least for some replies. Good, very good. I should, Vishal also understanding, good. So now here, we'll go for now tier diagram. Tier diagram of Rankine cycle. So we'll go for, now you understand first and then we'll go for, because this is very important diagram. So tier diagram is, here we have to draw. Tier diagram, okay. So this is, we know that this is going to be saturation curve and like this, it is get tapered. This is going to be critical point. Okay, so this is going to be saturated liquid line, we can say. This is a vapor line. One is liquid line, one is what? Vapor line. Now we here, this is our constant on tier diagram. Nature of concentration line is like this. So this is our two lines in there. One is, this is two lines. There are two pressures in the cycle. This is the nature of the constant pressure lines. I think you all learned in chapter number 2. If another pressure is there, it will be like this. So pressure here on tier diagram, this is constant pressure line. And this is a, which pressure? This is a boiler pressure. Highest pressure is in boiler. I can write boiler. And less pressure is there in, where it is there? Anybody of you? Where it is the pressure? A low pressure is there in the cycle? Which device? It is in condenser. Boiler is having more pressure, highest pressure, and in condenser. Okay, good. Asmita, it is going to be condenser is having less pressure. So first of all, what we'll do? Here 4-1 will start the process. So this is a boiler process. Okay. So let us consider that point number 4 is lying here. A complete liquid is there, and this liquid was supplying to the boiler. So 4-1 here. Now this will be, let us consider dry and saturated steam is generated from the boiler. So 4-1 is the process where dry and saturated steam is generated from the boiler. So this happens in boiler. Afterward, this 1-2, after dry and saturated steam is generated, no water vapor, water particles, moisture particles are present in the steam, and that is here supplied to the turbine. So this one process, this steam is dry, saturated steam is supplied to the turbine. In the turbine, what will happen? Isentropic expansion. Therefore, temperature will definitely decrease, and but entropy will remain. Anybody? Entropy will remain. Isentropic means entropy will remain. Entropy will remain constant. Not, it will not change during isentropy process. In the steam turbine, entropy will remain same. Now 2-3, there will be heat constant pressure. So heat is going to be rejected from this particular steam, okay, and due to that here 2-3 and they will get complete condensation. We're getting what? Complete condensation. And this happens in, this process happens in what? Condenser. CO. Okay, so this is happens in boiler, this is happens in condenser, this will happens in B for boiler. Okay, boiler, steam turbine and condenser. Now 3-4, what is this 3-4 condition is there? From this, we have to go for isentropic compression. But up to which pressure? This is a pressure line. This is a boiler pressure. Up to this line, where this particular vertical line, isentropic line from condenser to strike intersect this particular boiled pressure line, this will be our point number 4, not this. Okay, and this is here. To understand this, I have initially written point number 4 here. And this is called as what? Here, heat pump process. This process happens in P for pump. Okay, 3 to 4 isentropic compression pump, and thereafter what? 3 to 4 means 4 to 1 means what? Here, up water will, when it water is supplied, let us say 30 degree Celsius, then up to 100 degree Celsius, its temperature will what? Increase. This is sensible heat of water. So these four, this plus this latent heat, this is sensible heat plus latent heat, is added in the boiler. Sensible means from that point, actual point at temperature of that particular water to saturation temperature. So this temperature is called a saturation temperature at boiler. T sat, what, why? Because the temperature at which phase conversion occurs is called a saturation temperature. Mi sensible heat na kay hoil, while the water the saturation temperature parent temperature vadla jail, what do the water will take the heat, it will utilize it to increase the temperature. Pan ekda saturation latent saturation temperature reach zalya nantar kay hoil, fakt sagli heat kashyasathi vaparla jail, phase change sathi. That okay, so 4 to 1, this is 4 to 1, entire process 4 to 1, he ani he. And this is called as entire Rankine cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Everybody understand this? So this you have to make dark while you are drawing. Understand? Anybody having doubt on this? Then draw this. Understand, no doubt, very good. Yes sir, understood. Others please reply. Jagannath Avtade, very good. After a long time, Jagannath, very good to see you on chat box. Mayuri Vijay Bahad, okay, very good. Reply, then I am getting some confidence that students are understanding. Otherwise I am getting that after I am teaching whether to you whether you are understanding or not, because this is online mode. Understand, this is what? Now write down this name of this particular diagram is the TS diagram of which steam, what steam is supplied to the turbine. So they are asking these diagrams for in the examination. Dipali Gorya, yes sir, understand, very good Dipali. So TS diagram is of, or TS diagram of for which steam? TS diagram for dry saturated steam supplied to turbine, like this way to write. TS for dry and saturation steam diagram for dry and saturated steam to the again supplied to turbine. It is for dry and saturated steam supplied to turbine. TS for dry and saturated steam supplied to turbine. Now we'll go for, understand, we okay, draw this diagram and afterwards complete overview diagram. Write down TS for dry and saturated steam supplied to turbine. So first of all, draw this and tell me over completed. ऑफ और तो दिस लाइंस लाइक और ग्राफिक्स दिस लाइंस वी हैव टू ड्रॉ विथ फेंट लाइंस बॉयलर प्रेशर एंड दिस इज अप टू प्रैक्टिस और टू मेक दिस टू प्रेशर लाइंस टीयर डायग्राम फेंट लाइन एंड अपरोड दिस साइकिल पॉलीगॉन इज देयर दिस इज कॉल्ड एज रैंकिन साइकिल पॉलीगॉन 1 2 3 4 1 दिस वन This is our ranking cycle polygon. This is ranking cycle polygon. Completed, please reply. Sarvade over other please reply Over. Okay, now we'll go for same diagram only for what I get to make the practice DS diagram for wet steam supplied to turbine. I will write only for TS for wet steam. स्प्रेड ऑन अदर पार्ट सप्लाइड टू टर्बाइन, टीएस फॉर वेट स्टीम। Supply to turbine. So again, write down this is a TS diagram. Actually, one diagram here. So this is the nature of this. Our this is a critical point. I am drawing a little bit rough, but critical point. So this is liquid. This is vapor line. This is liquid line. This is liquid and this is vapor. This is critical point. Again, we have to draw two lines with fan line. How many pressures are there? Two. This is a boiler pressure line. So this will be H temperature remaining constant. Condenser pressure. Condenser. Or P condenser. P condenser, this is P boiler. Now 4 to 1, let us consider this 4 to 1 or 1 point here. Wet steam now. Wet steam means point number one will live here. Anybody of you? Where to lie? Left hand side, not on this. This is a wet, means it will contain some part of water particles, moisture. Your point number one will lie here. Or we can take it as one dash if it is one dash or one. So this will be our Laguerre diagram only, but it will not start in from this line because it is a here saturated, dry and saturated. Here it is wet, means some part of vapor liquid is there still. Then other diagram 2 to 2, this is happens in steam turbine. Okay, 2 to 3, no change. 2 to 3 is complete condensation, and 3 to 4 up to this compression vertical line and exact vertical. Okay, this 3 to 4, then entire this is a sensible heat, this is latent heat, and entire this will be happens in boiler, heat addition in boiler, and this happens in pump, P for pump. Okay, and this C for condenser. So this is the diagram for here. Wet steam, here diagram for wet steam supplied to steam turbine. Everybody understand? Point number one will not lie on this air saturated vapor line because all liquid is not converted into vapor, but for dry, it is all vapor is converted into liquid. Everybody understand this? And this is our Rankine cycle polygon. If I will draw it with another ink line, you will see ink color. Again, good, very good. I am not using this option. Very good. This is our Rankine cycle polygon for wet steam. Understand? Please reply. Very good. Jagannath Outada, yes, sir. Very good. Asmita Sarudi, understood. Adarsh, something I am getting now. Good name. Adarsh Narayan. Very good. So draw this. This is wet steam supplied to the turbine. Draw diagram and tell me over if it is over. TA diagram, make it practice. ओवर प्लीज रिप्लाई। मीन सर डोर ऑर्डर प्लीज रिप्लाय। प्रेरणा वानखेडे ओवर प्लीज। व्हेरी गुड। अदर्स दीपाली गोरे नॉट इन लेक्चर नाउ। विजय भाड़ ओके ओवर। मयूरी अभंगराव आदर्श नारायण ओवर सर। गुड दीपाली गोरे ओवर। वेरी गुड दीपाली। ज्ञानेश जानकर ओवर। गुड ज्ञानेश। ओके देन विल गो टू अनदर डायग्राम। विच डायग्राम विच टीम इज रिमेन नाउ एनीबडी ऑफ यू। विच टीम इज रिमेन। चार्ट बॉक्स वेरी गुड। अस्मिता सर सुपर हीटेड। वेरी गुड अस्मिता वेरी गुड। नाउ सुपर हीटेड टीम हाउ टू ड्रॉ डायग्राम नाउ। Right on. Superheated steam. Okay, very good. Superheated steam supplied to turbine. Very good color writing I have taken. Color was missing. Superheated steam. It is not spitting also. Good. Superheated steam supplied to turbine. That you write, huh? Because for me it is difficult to write on this. White board, white screen. TS, write down TS for TS diagram for superheated steam supplied to turbine. TS diagram for superheated steam supplied to turbine. You write down good in TS. Okay. This is saturation curve. Okay, this is critical point. This is liquid line. This is vapor line. Now again, two lines are there. One is what? Boiler pressure line. And another is. Condenser pressure. So this is condenser pressure. This is boost pressure. Boiler. P boiler. And let us consider superheated steam. Means where it will occur? This is dry saturated, and when temperature will increase, the superheated steam, it will again temperature will increase like this. So this will be our point number one. Will lie in the superheated zone. So this is superheated zone on boiler pressure, point number one. And from that, here you go for Mayuri zero. Abhangrao, lecture is over, timing is over. Mayuri Abhangrao, we want to end the lecture. Mayuri, can we end lecture? Wanted to give attendance. What is the problem? One to two will be, this will be 1 point. Superheated steam, because which steam, which point is there? Because steam is now superheated. Okay, so 1 to 2 happens in steam turbine. Okay, this will be happens in condenser. CV means condenser, right? Not complete. So here heat rejection in condenser, 2 to 3 heat rejection condenser, complete condensation, and from that 3 to 4 entire vertical line. Why vertical? Because isentropic compression. For me, it's somewhat difficult. देन 2 to 3, 3 to 4 एसेंट्रोपिक वो एग्जैक्ट वर्टिकल लाइन। मैंने 3 to 4 ओके एंड दिस विल बी एंटर। नाउ हीट एडिशन इन बॉयलर, दिस इज सेंसिबल हीट ओके फ्रॉम व्हाट वी कॉल कंप्रेस्ड लिक्विड टू सैचुरेशन टेम्परेचर, दिस इज फेज चेंज, लेटेंट हीट, फेज लेटेंट हीट एंड देन दिस इज अ सुपर हीट, सेम म्हणजे अनदर काइंड ऑफ सेंसिबल हीट। वन सेंसिबल हीट फॉर लिक्विड टू गेट अप टू द सैचुरेशन टेम्परेचर, एट सैचुरेशन टेम्परेचर फेज चेंज विल ऑकर एंड आफ्टर फेज चेंज ऑल्सो वी हीटेड द स्टीम डेट इट्स टेम्परेचर विल इंक्रीज सेंसिबली। सो फोर दिस इज हीटिंग हीट एडिशन हैविंग दिस वन पार्ट, दिस इज सेंसिबल हीट, देन इट इज लेटेंट हीट एंड इट इज सुपर हीट, थ्री पार्ट्स आर देयर एंड 1 to 2 इन स्टीम टर्बाइन। अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज डायग्राम फॉर द सुपर हीटेड स्टीम, एवरीबडी अंडरस्टैंड, यू कैन गो फॉर 1 double dash। अंडरस्टैंड प्लीज रिप्लाई। नॉट लाइक मयूरी अभंगराव, शी वॉन्टेड टू स्टॉप द लेक्चर, प्लीज गिव रिमार्क, दिस इज अवर सुपर हीटेड स्टीम बिकॉज जगन्नाथ अंडरस्टूड सर, बिकॉज इट इज नेचर ऑफ द कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर लाइन इज लाइक दिस। स्मित अंडरस्टूड, जगन्नाथ, सो ओनली 2 replies आई गॉट, अदर्स प्लीज रिप्लाय। असावरी भोसले, व्हेरी गुड असावरी, अंडरस्टैंड, इफ यू आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग एवरीबडी थिंग यू विल अंडरस्टैंड। आदर्श नारायण, यस सर, आदर्श नारायण ऑल्सो एग्री विथ मी, इफ यू आर कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग एवरी पॉइंट एवरी लेक्चर यू विल अंडरस्टैंड। रॉजिस टेल मी राइट टू बी ओवर, I'm taking this very slowly because this is used for numericals, to solve the numericals on Rankine cycle. These diagrams we have to use, these diagrams. ओवर, नो अस्मिता नॉट, अस्मिता सर वगैरह ओवर, प्रेरणा वानखेडे, अस्मिता सर वगैरह, जगन्नाथ अवताडे ओवर, प्लीज रिप्लाय, यस सर ओवर, ओके गुड, 1 minute, आदर्श नारायणकर, ओके विल गिव 1 minute टू आदर्श, नो प्रॉब्लम, बट वी बी फास्ट little that I will make ready, you draw this again, concentrate also and you draw. So when combined, in some books they have given combined diagram for tier diagram. Now we can draw a combined one diagram. In only one diagram we can represent all these parts. Yes, sir. Or other good, good. Other tier diagram now for combined diagram, you can see common for this is nature of constant pressure line. This is boiler pressure. This will be condenser pressure. Let us consider first dry and saturated in case. One point here we know this will be isentropic expansion. 0.1 to 2. Okay. 2 to 3 is complete condensation. To make you one only one line, condenser 2 to 3, and from 3 to 4. Happens in from. Sensible heat plus latent heat. It's in boiler. This is happens in steam turbine. 1 to 2, then 2 to 3, 3 to 4. This is saturated, here dry and saturated steam. So in same diagram, if wet steam is there, then I can represent it by. Make it vertical, because I'm little bit 1, 2 dash, and same diagram if the separate steam is there, then two double dash. Here we can write 1 double dash. This 1 double dash, 2 double dash, 3, 4, 1 double dash, superheated Rankine cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 as usual dry and saturated cycle. 1 dash, 2 dash, 3, 4, 1 dash. This is a wet steam cycle. So this is a 1, 2, 2. 1 dash will be wet. 1 dash is this condition of wet. And 1 double, 1 means dry and saturated. And 1 double dash means it is. Okay, now draw. Poor, understand? No problem. It is a common diagram. Combined. All diagrams we can draw in only one diagram, depending on situation. And depending on situation, one can only one at one case, only one is applicable. If the steam may be dry, or either dry, either wet, or either superheated. Take a particular condition apply. Understand and draw. ओवर, प्लीज रिप्लाई। हाँ ओवर, प्लीज रिप्लाई। नो वन क्रेडिट कंप्लीटेड, गुड, अदर्स नॉट एन ओवर सर, ओके। Now we'll go for HS diagram of Rankine cycle. PU diagram I think we have understood. TA diagram we have understood. Now HS diagram. We'll go for common case HS diagram. Of Rankine cycle. Now, HS diagram is enthalpy on XX, Y-axis. X-axis entropy. So again, this is nature of, okay. And this is going to be on HS diagram, nature of pressure line, contribution line is like this. This is a boiler pressure. This is no step. This is like this nature. This is a condenser pressure. Now, 1 to 2, if you go for 1 to 2, so this will be boiler. Dry and saturated steam, let us consider supplied to the turbine. As it is, yes, is there. It is going to be 1 to 2. Okay. Then 2 to 3 complete condensation, let us consider. Then 2 to 3. This is 3 to 4. Happens in pump. This much is the heat is added. Enthalpy is added. Boiler. Yes, means steam turbine ST will write. This is the HS diagram for the here dry and saturated steam supplied to the steam turbine. If it is wet steam, only thing is there, the one point will be the dotted line we can show. 1-2, you write down that 1-2 means wet steam. And if it is superheated, 1-2. So this is nature. So this is the enthalpy difference, H1 minus H4. So how much enthalpy is added in this here? H1 minus H4. Or if it is wet steam, H1 minus H4. If it's superheated, 1-2 minus H4. Okay. So corner enthalpy, point enthalpy will be inlet to the boiler enthalpy will be H4. Okay. At after boiler means here it will be H1, after turbine it will be H2, okay. Then H3 means here it will be in entry to the condenser, sorry, H2 means after after condensation, and H4 means these are four enthalpies. Everybody understand this? Please tell. HS diagram, nature of constant pressure line is like this. So this is nature. We cannot change this nature. It is real nature of the constant pressure line on HS diagram. अंडरस्टैंड नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग और नो बडी प्लीज रिप्लाई एंड ड्रॉ ऑल्सो एचर डायग्राम अदर्स नारायण यस सर अंडरस्टैंड गुड अंडरस्टूड सर ओके सॉरी सॉरी इट इज आई अस्मिता हैज गिवन मैसेज अदर्स हैज ऑल्सो गिवन मैसेज अदर्स प्लीज रिप्लाई एंड ड्रॉ डायग्राम एंड मेक अनदर रिप्लाई टू ओवर सर So repeat what is H1, H2 and H4. Okay, H1 means what? Here it is boiler process. H1 means what? The enthalpy of steam after boiler or heat of steam after boiler. H2 means what? The entire process will complete in steam turbine. 2 means what? It is exit point at turbine. So it is what? Enthalpy of steam entering to after turbine exit at the point exit to turbine and entering to condenser. H3 means after enthalpy of steam, specific enthalpy of steam at the end of condenser, and 4 means before at the entry of the boiler. Depending on the device, boiler la dai chari enter enthalpy kite H4 boiler modun plus enthalpy gain keli hit kadun dai combustion of fuel kadun ani tyachi enthalpy wadli असं Y-axis ला म्हणजे इन्क्लिनेशनला गेल्यामुळे वाढली H1 ओके अंडरस्टँड प्लीज मेन्शन क्वेश्चन यू हॅव आस्क्ड आय हॅव रिपीटेड येस सर अंडरस्टँड गुड व्हेरी गुड व्हेरी गुड प्रेरणा दिस काइंड ऑफ अप्रोच इफ यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टँडिंग देन यू हॅव टू आस्क diagram over I think one
yes sir
no Mayuri you are understood
yes sir
writing drawing but you are not replying in chat box
सॉरी सर ते जरास बाहेर आहे नी त्याच्यामुळे जरास रायटिंग नाही केलं पण लक्ष आहे सर
ओके बाहेर कसं ओके डोंट गिव्ह रिअल मेसेज रिअलिस्टिक मेसेज हियर हियर ओके ओके okay now we have to go for efficiency of Rankine cycle if how to calculate the efficiency yeah then make this will end of today's means after this we'll end our lecture you know 15 minutes will require so concentrate now if how to calculate efficiency of Rankine cycle Now here, as process is not isothermal, therefore we cannot use that TDS formula. Therefore, directly we can get the enthalpy difference. As it is an isobaric process, directly we will get the enthalpy difference. From that, we will calculate the efficiency. So heat supplied in boiler, how we will calculate? Anybody of you? We require heat supplied in boiler. Means enthalpy supplied in boiler, heat supplied in boiler. How we will calculate? Yes, heat supplied in boiler. How? What is heat supplied in boiler? If you go for enthalpy before entering to the boiler, at the entrance of the boiler is H4. At the exit, let us consider one steam, any dry non-saturated steam, any one. Okay. Here the diagram. One thing remember, kara. Okay. I will remove others. ओके एंथाल्पी बिफोर बॉयलर और एट द एंट्री ऑफ बॉयलर इज एच फोर हे जे एंथाल्पी काय असणार आहे एच फोर इथं आणि इथे एंथाल्पी काय असणार आहे H1 हाउ मच एंथाल्पी हीट इज ऍडेड इन बॉयलर हीट सप्लाइड मीन्स दॅट इज हीट सप्लाइड इन बॉयलर किती हीट घेतली वॉटरनं फ्लुइडनं एनीबडी ऑफ यू एनीबडी विल गिव एन्सर Nobody? Okay, I what? H4 is taken. H4 heat is taken. But how much? Initially, it is having enthalpy H1. How much in boiler it has taken? Pahinandhi jara water la kaya jara enthalpy hoti H1. H4 is hoti. H4 hoti. Jitha kya nangiri H4 is? H4 nahi kya nangiri. Kaya manada apon? H1 minus H4. Manja H1 jasta hai. Ani H4 kaya hai? Teji pahili enthalpy. Manja boiler madhi kiti kiti cycle madhi? H1 minus H4. Understand? Like this, heat rejected in condenser. Kiti heat reject kiya the condenser la? Heat rejected in condenser. H2 minus H3. Very good. QR is equal to what? Kiti asnar hai? Initial la kiti? We'll go to diagram. H2 manje poteji ahe enthalpy hoti. Just enthalpy hoti. Condenser la pan. Heat reject kele amal kaya dhali? Ita add apan atle zahashti pan diagram kore shukta. Here we are supplying the heat. QS. Tacha amal enthalpy waad se. And ita reject karto QR. Manon tacha enthalpy. Kami ji? कमी होते H2 minus H3 heat rejected very good Asmita किती येणार H2 minus H3 आता any cycle efficiency we know that what is efficiency eta Rankine is equal to what The Rankine is equal to what? Work obtained. Okay. W. Okay. Net we can say or obtained. Net work obtained divided by heat supplied QS. Or net work obtained means cash cycles happen. It nothing but heat supplied minus heat rejected. Heat supplied varun heat rejected difference the sale. All heat is can convert in heat can be converted into work. QS minus QR divided by QS. And therefore. Eta Rankine is in this case is coming as what? H1 minus H4. And this enthalpy we have to find out from the steam table in the numericals. Minus H2 minus H3 divided by heat supplied H1 minus H4. Understand this formula? Please reply. With the help of this formula, one can find out the efficiency of Rankine cycle by using the enthalpies. Because this is constant pressure forces. Therefore, we cannot use the formula. DS is equal to or DQ is equal to TDS. TDS could operate factor isothermal law. We have to only use isobaric. Therefore, H1 minus H4. Minus H2 minus H3. Understand? Only one reply. Yes, sir. Understood. Others, please reply. And then write down also this formula, efficiency, because numerical solving it is coming. Jagannath Avtade, yes, sir. Very good. Others, please reply and write down this efficiency. Okay, and I will give 2 minutes to you to write this. And again, one formula is there. From this formula only, rabbi another method. Yes, sir, understood. Shiv Prasad Karandai. Oh, good, very good. Another name is there. Shiv Prasad something. Roll number 48. Shiv Prasad, very good. Like this, you reply Shuprasad always in message box. Still, I am not getting only 5, maximum 6 to 7 students are giving reply. Others 45. What they are doing, I don't know. Traveling, eating, or doing work by putting mobile at the corner. I don't know. Or by only attending mute and volume, less volume. Maybe like this software, maybe also there, that 10 here. Sure, sir. Good. Shuprasad, good. Very good. And then complete the write-up. Completed. Very good, Asmita. Okay, others, please complete. Carnot cycle, efficiency is function of temperature. These are efficiency. Carnot cycle also you can calculate also by this way. But also it is simple to only by knowing the temperature. In heat addition temperature and heat rejection temperature, we have to get efficiency of Carnot. But here we have to get the 4 side enthalpies, H1, H2, H3, H4, and then we will get the enthalpy. Gohar, shall we go to next page? Yes, sir. Over Adarsh Narayankar. Very good. Sujal Chandanshwe, you want to speak? Anything, Sujal?
No, sir.
Okay, okay. Understanding, Sujal?
Yeah, yeah.
But not writing, not responding. Writing? Writing or not, Sujal?
In...
Okay. Okay. Now another also formula is there. We can calculate the efficiency. Is eta Rankine, write down. Eta Rankine is equal to. Same formula will come, but another. Eta Rankine is equal to what? W net, net work obtained divided by heat supplied QS. But net work obtained means what? One device is generating the work and one device is consuming work. Which device is generating work? Anybody of you? Anybody of you? Which device is consuming work? And which device is generating work? Kutla device? Okay. I got a boiler generating, not boiler. Which work generating device? What is work generating device, Asmita? Not boiler. Boiler is supplying heat, heat supplying. But work generating, which is working? Work, where we are obtaining work? In our diagram. I think I got the correct. Turbine generates work. Very good, Prerna. Good. Where generating work? Turbine. Turbine is generating work. And who is consuming? Where we are doing compression. Pump is compressor or pump. Pump is consuming the work. Okay. So here it is what? Therefore, we can write W net is equal to work obtained in steam turbine. Steam turbine not tire kill the work. But some work we have to give to pump, W pump. And divided by heat supplied. Heat supplied means QS. Now, again, here also we can get with the help of enthalpy difference. We know that by the first law of thermodynamics, heat is converted into work. Means WST means what? Jevda steam turbine madun entry. If you go to the here, enthalpy kita steam turbine chi entry la H1. Ani ज्या वेळेस स्टीम टर्बाईन कडून तो लिव होतो स्टीम, जी एन्थाल्पी किती होते एच टू, म्हणजे इथं ही सप्लाय इथं एच वन आहे, इथं एच टू आहे, राहिली कुठे गेली तर इट इज कन्वर्टिंग इन टू वर्क, म्हणजे एच वन मायनस एच टू विल बी द वर्क ऑप्टेन इन द स्टीम टर्बाईन. व्हॉट इज फॉर्म्युला? एच वन मायनस एच टू मायनस इन ब्रॅकेट पंपचं नाव पंप एन्थाल्पी, बघा एन्थाल्पी एच डायग्रामला एन्थाल्पी कोणा जास्त असणार आहे, एच डायग्राम एच फोर आणि एच थ्री, म्हणजे पंपनं कंझ्युमर किती केलं, इथं पहिले त्याची एन्थाल्पी एच थ्री होती आणि इथे किती आहे एच फोर, म्हणजे एच फोर मायनस एच थ्री. एच फोर मायनस एच थ्री म्हणजे मगाचाच फॉर्म्युला आहे, फक्त ह्या मेथडने सुद्धा आपल्याला, म्हणजे ह्या फॉर्म्युला सुद्धा आपल्याला वी आर गेटिंग सेम आन्सर एच वन मायनस एच फोर. मग फॉर्म्युला घेतला आपण, ब्रॅकेट सॉल्व केल्या तर सेम फॉर्म्युला विल गेट, ओके एच वन मायनस एच टू आणि एच फोर, इथं काय झालं मायनस एच थ्री मायनस, इथं आपण मायनस साईन दिलो त्यामुळं इथं काय होणार आहे एच फोर मायनस एच थ्री. ओके अंडरस्टँड, दिस इज अनदर फॉर्म्युला टू कॅल्क्युलेट द एफिशियंसी, सेम फॉर्म्युला बट ओनली बाय अनदर दिस वे. डब्ल्यू नेटवर्क मीन्स, नेटवर्क म्हणजे काय, काही वर्क आपण जनरेट करतो काही वर्क आपल्याला द्यावं लागतं. अंडरस्टूड अस्मिता, नो प्रॉब्लेम. ऑदर्स प्लीज रिप्लाय. आदर्श नारायणकर, येस सर, गुड, व्हेरी गुड. प्रेरणा वानखेडे, अंडरस्टूड. ऑदर्स, दीपाली गोरे, नॉट अटेंडिंग लेक्चर आफ्टरवर्ड्स. जगन्नाथ अवताडे, मयुरी अभंगराव ट्रॅव्हलिंग, ओके सुजल चंदन शिवे, अंडरस्टँडिंग. महेश समथिंग इज महेश, ओंकार देवकर, व्हेरी गुड. अंडर दीपाली गोरे, येस सर, अंडरस्टँड. ओके महेश, अंडरस्टँडिंग ना विभूते,
येस सर.
ओके बट नॉट इंटरॅक्टिंग इन चॅट बॉक्स महेश. शिंदे इज देअर
प्रॉब्लेम,
रेंज प्रॉब्लेम, ऍटलीस्ट रायटिंग प्रॉब्लेम. ओके ओके शिंदे इज देअर, ओके राईट डाऊन दिस. सो विथ दिस शॅल वी एंड टुडे, वी जस्ट विल सी what we have today, what we have completed up to this. No, okay, so limitation because I wanted to, this notes is good, but here steam entering through turbine is dry and saturated, this diagram we have completed, this turbine is dry and saturated, superheated steam, HS diagram also we have completed, efficiency of Rankine cycle we have completed. Next class we will go for actual Rankine cycle, okay, and then directly numericals will start. ठीक आहे, टुमॉरो नेक्स्ट टू आवर्स फोर आवर्स फोर फाईव्ह आवर्स विल कम्प्लीट दिस. वी विल गो स्लोली, वेदर वी शुड गो स्लोली ऑर फास्टली, टेल मी, ऑर वी दिस इज गुड स्पीड ना, ऑर शॅल आय गो लिटल बिट फास्ट, इफ यू वॉन्ट देन आय कॅन गो फास्ट, बिकॉज देन वी विल कम्प्लीट सिलेबस व्हेरी अर्ली, देअर फोर